Hello everyone and welcome to this week's Game Development Log video diary, and this week I'm going to be working on ranged attacks and adding food into the game. So to kick off the week, I've been adding projectiles into the game, and if I do this ranged attack you can see an example of a projectile being fired. And this seems all good and well, but when I use the actual arrow model you can see that there is a bit of a problem. The arrow always faces exactly the same direction, and so tomorrow I'm going to have to work on calculating the Euler rotation of the arrow depending on the direction it is fired in. Tuesday, and today I've been struggling through a lot of maths to try and get the arrow rotations to work, and I think I've finally managed it. So if I shoot the arrow, it now faces the direction in which it is travelling. But as well as that, I've also made sure that the arrow's rotation around the horizontal axis is correct, so if I turn the power of the bow down and fire the arrow again, you can see the arrow rotating nicely over its movement arc. Today I've added collision detection to projectiles, so the arrows now stick into walls and trees when they hit them, like this. The arrows also collide with the ground as well, which you can see here, and the arrows will stay there for 50 seconds or so before they disappear. It is Thursday and I've added some food into the game. If we have a look at this shop here, we can see that there is now a food category which offers up a colourful array of different foods. So if I buy a few fish and some bread, you can see that I've added this eat option which I can select to eat some lovely raw fish. Friday, and today I've added this food meter that shows you how hungry your player is, and I've also added these cute little icons to show which bar is which. When you eat food, the meter increases, and the amount that it goes up depends on the food's fillingness. I couldn't think of a better word. But the more filling a food is, the more the meter increases. And of course, the meter also slowly decreases over time, and the speed that it decreases at depends on the energy release speed of the foods you've eaten. Again, I probably need a better name for that as well. And I've used words here instead of number values for these stats because I thought it would help with the immersion and all that, but I'm not sure. Let me know what you guys think about that. Today I improved the food meter so that it now changes colour to indicate the status of your hunger, and I've sped up the rate that the meter decreases at here to demonstrate this colour change. When the bar is empty you now start to take damage every 5 seconds, but it's very slow so you have plenty of time to go and get some food. I don't really want starving to be an issue that you have to constantly worry about, but I do like the idea of you having to take a bit of time out occasionally to go to a shop or an inn once in a while to have a meal. But anyway, I'll eat some fish and bread to bring the food meter back up, and you can see the meter changing back to green. But if I eat too much, the bar starts to go red again to indicate that you are too full, so you have to balance your meals nicely. And if you're too hungry or too full, you'll actually hit up to 40% lower in combat. But if the food meter is in the green, then you'll be able to hit a little bit harder. And that is it for this week. In the next few weeks, I've actually got my final university exams and my dissertation deadline, so progress on the game might be a little slow for a while. So I hope you guys can forgive me if the videos are a bit less frequent for the next few weeks. But yeah, thank you guys very much for watching this video. Do subscribe if you haven't already. Have a brilliant week, and I will see you all next time.